Hello all, I am Raquel Moreno, project manager working for AXIA Innovation, a small innovation consultancy based in Munich, Germany. We are focused on knowledge management, technology transfer, dissemination campaigns, and exploitation and business models. As part of the Surfbio project, we have developed this MOOC targeting the European project funding from proposal stage to project management. In chapter one, I will present a downline of the Horizons Europe framework. And at the end, you will have a general understanding on what this funding program is and how you can benefit by requesting funding. The Horizons Europe framework is a six-year European key funding program focused on research and innovation with a total budget of more than 95 billion euros. The program facilitates collaboration and enhances the influence of research and innovation in developing, supporting, and implementing European policies while also addressing the global challenges. The budget allocated for this program has experienced a significant increase over time, starting from 3,000 million in the first program and reaching now more than 96,000 million at present. This upward trend reflects the Europeans' strong commitment to this primary research and innovation instrument, highlighting the growing importance of science and technology in the society to tackle our pressing challenges. The ambition of Horizons Europe is to achieve a strategic connection among a powerful science, developing technological excellence and making the research stronger, serving for society, tackling the European and international policy priorities such as Green Deal, digital transition, and the Sustainable Development Goals, and also boosting the economy through Europe, being more competitive and creating new jobs and a skill force. Horizons Europe has set up also missions in order to bring concrete solutions to some of our greatest challenges. These European missions will support Europe's transformation into a greener, healthier, and more inclusive and resilient continent. So they aim to bring these benefits to people in Europe and engage the Europeans for the design and implementation. The five missions established are the cancer, to improve the lives of more than 3 million people. The second one is to make more than 150 regions and communities climate resilient. Also to restore our oceans and waters. To achieve 100 climate neutral and smart cities, and to create more than 100 living labs and lighthouses to lead the transition towards healthy soils. These ambitious goals should be achieved by 2030 with concrete results. Horizons Europe is divided into big research blocks. The first one is the research focused on defense. The second one, which is the one in the middle in this slide, it's focused on civil applications into three different pillars. Pillars one targets excellence and science, aiming at developing new skills and knowledge among the academia and researchers. Pillar two, which is the biggest pillar with the highest funding from the Horizons Europe, targets the global challenges like climate change, environment, digital transitions, and also industrial competitiveness. Pillar three has an objective to advance innovation in Europe. And then besides this, part of the budget supports widening and strengthening the European research area. In addition, we have this Euratom program, which focuses on research and training in nuclear fusion and fission research training. Going into pillar two, which is the most important one for research and innovation. It offers opportunities for funding for industries and scientists focusing on civil research, as I mentioned before. It is divided in six clusters, and each of them has a target's main vision, establishing areas of intervention and outlining the expected impacts that the applications within this cluster should embrace. In addition, we have the Joint Research Center is at the bottom of the slide, and it aims to generate high quality scientific evidence for good public policies with extra independent advice and support. So Horizons Europe has a top-bottom approach. So has set up a strategic plan, which has strategic orientations that last for 4 years. These strategic orientations and impact areas are formulated on the basis of the expected impacts where the research is expected to make a huge difference. And this expected impact is targeted by this work program. These are also having the destinations because they indicate the direction of this research and the goal that the expected contribution should achieve. Within the work program, we have different topics, and these have a detailed description of the dedicated actions that the European Commission is expecting. And also here, the expected outcomes of these actions are described. At the end, we should make a proposal or a project, or if it's becoming a project, with some expected results that are targeting this topic, work program, and strategic plan impacts and expected results. Horizon Europe participants are not only the 27 member states, but also important non-European countries can benefit for the funding, as well as specific areas. So it is important to go through each of the documents in order to understand who are the eligibility criteria, as there are some, could be some changes and specificities in the work programs. So how you can search for the topics and the different funding schemes? There is the funding and tenders portal that I included here as screenshots. And the portal offers supports with guidelines and different documents, also in different European languages. You can also search on the left-hand side for the submission status or other previous programs, as I mentioned before, and get all the information about ongoing projects and also submitted proposals. The last point I would like to comment here is the national contact points. So Horizons Europe has established this national network that not only includes the 27 member states, but it's broadened to also associated countries. And it is recommended to contact your national contact points in order to get support and advice on any kind of queries that you have of Horizons Europe as a funding scheme. So they can support you on select which is your most treatable topic that will address your novelty or your development and also the field of expertise. They can support by finding partners. They can also support on offering trainings and how to write a good proposal that tackles all the points in order to be competitive. So here I added the link for you to go and check and where is your national contact point, and really strongly recommend in case you are interested in contact them. So this was all from my side. Many thanks for following this chapter, and I hope you understand a little bit better the Horizons Europe framework and can how you can search for funding. I recommend you to check also the other chapters of this MOOC to get a full overview of how you can go from a proposal stage to a project management stage. Thank you very much.